Good morning, students. Today we are going to see zoology first lesson, chapter 1, the living world. The living world. In this living world, millions and billions of species of animals and plants are there. So already you know that. So in this billions and millions of species, how we are identified and how they are classified in a groups, these are seen in this lesson. So first we go to living world. You know that there means millions of species were only 8.7 million of species were only identified. So other remaining will be start to research, start undergo the research. So next we go to diversity in a diversity in a living world. So in a human, diversity in a living world. The earth has numerous habitat with a wide range of living organism inhabiting them. So the plants and animals are present in this diversity in the world. So there are variety of species that have been adopted successfully in the diversity of the world. So how the animals are present in this earth, that they are giving some diagrams to know how the animals are classified, animals and plants are classified in this earth. So next we go to the presence of a large number of species in a particular ecosystem is called biological diversity. So the term biodiversity was first introduced by Walter Rosen. So he is a person. So Walter Rosen so coined the name biodiversity. What is biodiversity? The presence of a large number of species in a particular ecosystem is called as a biological diversity, or shortly we called as a biodiversity. So in the what is different between living and non-living, or characteristic feature of living things? So living thing means they have a variety of unique characters or different from a non-living thing. What is the difference? Different characters we are seeing, a living and non-living. So living thing means the cellular organization is there, nutrients are there, respiration is taking place, metabolism is taking place, growth will be happen in the animal and plant. So the stimuli characters are there, movement they are, some and plants and animals are move or otherwise they are not move. So movement is also a character for the living thing. And homeostatic condition, excretion, reproduction, adaptation, these are the key characters of a living thing. So this is a character feature of living thing. So how we class, we know it's a living or non-living, this key character only we are knowing, that is a living or non-living. So needs for classification, why we want to classify the animals and plants. When we go to any shops or malls or any library, they are segregate items or books in some manners. So that means when you are going a mall, you are seeing groceries are one area and the vegetable things are one area. So these manner they are classified. So same like in our animals and plants are also want to classify. So what is classification? The process by which things are grouped convenient category based on easily absorbed. So this is called as character classification. Observing class characters in a easily method, it is called as a classification. So the scientific term used for these category is taxon. Taxon is a singular, taxon means plural. So what is classification? Why we want to classify? So we are easily absorb the animals and plants, so we want to classify, then only we are easily absorb. So what is classification? Classification is a process by which things are grouped in a convenient category based on the easily absorbing characters. So classification is a process by which things are grouped into the convenient category. So scientific term of this category is taxon. Singularly we call it as a taxon. Basic need for classification. So to identify the different animals, correlated species, to know variation among the species, to understand the evolutions of the species, to create a phylogenetic tree among the different group, to conveniently study the living organism. So these are a basic need we want to classify them animals, organisms. So what is taxonomy? Taxonomy and systematic. So the it is a Greek word. So taxis means arrangement, norms means law. In a particular manner we are arranged the animal, it is called taxonomy. So how we want to classify the living organism? So we want to the word taxonomy was coined by who? Augustine. The word taxonomy was coined by Augustine. So Aristotle is called as a father of taxonomy. Carolus Linnaeus is the father of modern taxonomy. Aristotle. Who is the father of modern taxonomy? It is Carolus Linnaeus. So systematics. What is systematics? The main criteria of systematic is identification, describing, naming, arranging, preserving and documenting the organism. It is a system. Systematic means when you go to anywhere, we are going to in the queue, man. So it's a system, systemic. So systematic. So we want to give a name to the animal, we want to classify one animal, we never give a simple method. So we want to prove how, why we want to giving a name to a particular animal. So in this manner, the main criteria of systematic means first we want to identify the animal and then describing animal. Describing means the animal having a 5 legs, 6 having a 6 wings, this like we are giving any describe. So next we want to give a name. So then we want to arranging the order. Then we want to plant means we want to preserve. Animal also we want to preserve in the form of a zoos or national park, that manner we want to preserve. So next documenting. So how, what are you describe, that described thing will be documented, because in further study this documenting only they are able to study. So this method is called as a systematics. So next we go to historical classification. So older stage how they are classified. So historical classification, historic early classification, first they are given so many classification, simply the domestic, wild, creeping, flying, sea animals. So these are based on the fundamental classification. So after that each and every persons they are given different type of a classification. So Aristotle was the first to classify the animal in historical history of animals. Animalias is given by Aristotle. So next animal were classified based on the how Aristotle classified the animals, plants and animals, particularly animals, how he classified animals were classified based on the locomotion. So how they are walking means terrestrial animal, flying means aerial animal, swimming means aquatic animal. So next based on the presence and absence of red blood cells he classified the animals. So this manner first Aristotle will be classified. In this Aristotle classification so many apportion is the, so many drawbacks are there. So he then next Aristotle after, so Theopetus, Aristotle after her student, a student Theopetus also classified the animals. So after that he was Theopetus is the father of botany, after the 16th century English naturalist John Ray is giving several important works in of life of animals. So next Carolus, Switzerland biologist Carolus Linnaeus, he is a father of modern taxonomy and founder of a modern systematic scientific system taxonomy. He talks taxonomy and binomial nomenclature also he used. So Carolus is a father of modern taxonomy. He only classify the animal in a binomial nomenclature method. So this method, the some other persons also given the classification. So next we go to phylogenetic classification or class statistics. So later on biologists initiated study on the evolutionary and phylogenetical relationship among the organism, which leads to emerge of phylogenetic classification or class statistics. So what is class statistic? So what is classistic? Means classistic means classification of, classification summarized genetically difference between all species in the form of phylogenetic tree, in the form of a phylogenetic tree. In this tree diagram is called as cladogram. So they are in, given in the form of a classistic classification means they giving in the form of phylogenetic tree, or the tree, the diagram is known as a cladogram. So this manner they are given a classification. So see here how the phylogenetic tree, that means how genetically variations of animals they are classified. So this manner they are giving a diagram, it is called as a cladogram. So next we go to some other animal, other persons giving a classification. So later into 4 or 5 or 6 and now 7 kingdoms are given, kingdoms are classified. So 7 kingdom classification is given by R.H. Whittaker. 7 kingdom classification is given by R.H. Whittaker. So what are the 7 kingdoms? Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantia and Animalia. This is a 7 kingdom classification. So in this classification is based on the, how they are classified, these 7 kingdom, based on the cell structure, nutrition, reproduction, phylogenetic relationship. These are the key role for a 7 kingdom classification. So then after that, with help of DNA and RNA, molecular DNA on India, we are classified the three domain classification. Classification has come to long way of now take account of even molecular level of DNA and RNA. Based on this kind of biochemical reaction, classification is taking place. That classification is called as a three domain classification. So three domain classification was coined by or proposed by Carl Woese. So three domain classification was proposed by Carl Woese. So what is the three domain classification? So in Carl Woese, see this diagram, we able to see how the three domain classification taking place. Archaea is coming from that means how they are single celled organism, prokaryotic organisms are coming under the archaea, and extremophilus. Next, bacteria, cyanobacteria are coming from the domain bacteria. So prokaryotes, they have DNA, the definite DNA, circular chromosome, not have a stone So they are these characteristic animals are coming under the bacteria. So next we go to domain eukarya. So where we see in the domain eukarya, eukaryotes are coming animals. So they are true nucleus, membranes are bound in organelles. So these type of organisms are coming under the eukarya. So these based they are classified three domains. So who classify the domain? Carrot. So next we come to next to the five kingdom classification. So based on the domain, after that some scientists are classified five kingdom classification. What is a five kingdom classification? So here see Monera, Protista, Fungi, Planetia, Animalia, these are the five kingdom classification. After that the Smith is given seven kingdom classification. What are the seven kingdom classification? Eubacteria and Archaebacteria. So these two are coming from prokaryotic classification. So next five is a eukaryotic animals. So what are the eukaryotic animals coming under the kingdom? Means protozoa, chromista, fungi, plantia and animalia. So these manner they are classified seven kingdom classification. So next we go to taxonomic history. So biological classification, how the biological classification is taking place? So namely they are categorized seven major category, that is kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. These and some other categories or the intermediate categories also we seen here. So what are the integrated category? Means that means subkingdom, grade, division, subdivision, subphylum, subclasses, so suborder. These are the other intermediate categories in the kingdoms. So here some diagrams are given, pictures are given. What are that? That is Hinni, Muli, Ligiri and Ligir and Tikon. So why these diagrams are given? This group of animals having similar morphological features, they reproductive isolated and produce fertile offsprings. So these animal producing sterile offspring, fertile offsprings are producing a sterile offsprings with our because of mating with closely related species. So how these animals are produced means the crosses between two different animals. Then inni means is crossed by male ass and female donkey producing inni. So male donkey, female ass producing mule. So male lion and female tiger producing Lika and male tiger and female lion producing Tikon. These four are sterile offspring. These four are sterile offsprings. So what is species? Species is a basic unit of classification. Next we go to genus. Genus, it's a group closely related species which evolved from a common ancestor, it is called as a genus. So it is monotypic genus author and polytypic genus also we seen here. So next we go to genus. After what is the family? So the taxonomic category which include group related to the genera with the less similar of compared to genus and species. So next we go to order. This category include assembling of one or more related families. Before family, one or two family combined to form a common features or combined to form a one order. So next we go to classes. Classes means the category included one or more related orders. Common categories are coming under to the class. So next we go to phylum. The phylum is group of classes similar distinct characteristic consists of a phylum. So in this phylum we are seeing
fishes, amphibia, reptiles, apes, mammals. So kingdom Animalia. The phylum is phylum fishes, amphibians, reptiles, apes, mammals, and next higher category of phylum is Chordata. So this manner the phylum is classified. Next we go to kingdom. So all living animals belong to various phyla are included in a kingdom Animalia. So these five kingdom phylums are coming under one kingdom, that is called as a Animalia. So next we go to nomenclature. So nomenclature means what? So we are giving a naming, so that is called as a nomenclature. So particular, I mean, we know that so many countries are there, so many language we are speaking, so we are giving so many types of name in one particular plant or one particular animal. So this will be rectified by method of nomenclature. Nomenclature means single naming used for, that is called as scientific naming. Giving some simple example, Homo sapiens. Human, we are saying human scientific naming is Homo sapiens. So naming of an organism done by based on a guidelines of International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. It is called ICZN. So there are two type of nomenclature. One is a binomial nomenclature. Another one is a trinomial nomenclature. Bi means two, nomen means name. Tri means three, nomen means name. So binomial nomenclature is universally accepted nomenclature. So the system of naming of organism is called binomial nomenclature. So they are using generic name and species name. So two names are combined to form a scientific name. It is called as a binomial nomenclature. Example, in our national bird, Indian bird, peacock, the name is pavo is a generic name. Crustaceous is a species name. Then same tiger, panther is a generic name and tigress is a species name. This manner, the two naming, tiger, panther, tigress. So that like we are giving two name is called as a binomial nomenclature. Trinomial nomenclature means we are giving a generic name, species name, subspecies name. We are using three names are called as a trinomial nomenclature. Example of trinomial nomenclature is Corvus splendens splendens. It is a house of crow. Corvus splendens splendens. Corvus is a generic name. Splendens is a species name. Splendens is a subspecies name. So here we are using taxonomy. Taxonomy means that a species name and generic name is same. It is called as a taxonomy. Good example of taxonomy is Indian cobra. It is seen here, Naja Naja. So species name is Naja and generic name is also Naja. So we giving same name. So it is called as a taxonomy. So rules of nomenclature. What is the rules of nomenclature? How we want to give a name? You are getting animals or plants. So how we are giving a name to particular animals? How we want to forming a name? So first the scientific name should be italicized. First name is a italicized name. So handwritten you are writing. So or otherwise used to underline separately. Generic name you want to put underline different separately. Generic and species name we are giving a different underlining, or otherwise we will use a italical. Next we go to generic name. Genus, first is a alphabetic name. Generic name is a alphabetic uppercase name. Species is a lowercase name. So third or fourth point, scientific name is any two organism are not in similar. A similar name, one particular animal or one particular organism, two different name we not able to give one. So next we the name or abbreviated name or scientific, who first published. So who first published that particular person's name only we want to come under recognition. So the species name is framed after from any person name or name of species shall be written. So these manner we want to use to rules of nomenclature. So next we go to concept of rules of nomenclature. These basic 6 rules we want to follow for nomenclature. Next we go to concept of species. So the term species were coined by John Ray, where we see this name is described in Historical Generalis Plantarum, and his book name is Historica Generalis Plantarum. John Ray coined the name species in the year 1693. So Carolus Linnaeus, in his book Systemia Natura, is considered species of basic units of species, is only a basic unit of classification. In 1859, Charles Darwin, in his book Origin of Species, explained the evolutionary concept of species in a natural selection method. So next we go to tools for study of taxonomy. So how we want to giving tools or aids. So which plant or animal you are taking, we want to give a different type of tools. So in a plant bins, we using herbariums, botanical gardens. We are using herbariums and botanical gardens. So in animals, plants mean botanical gardens and herbariums are we using. In animals mean museum, taxonomical keys we are using museum, and marine parks, zoological parks we are using. These are the tools for taxonomy. Next we go to classical taxonomic tool. So it is a taxonomic keys, museums, zoological park, marine park, printed taxonomic tools are used for different types of classical taxonomic tools. Molecular taxonomic tools, we are using DNA barcoding, DNA hybridization, DNA fingerprinting. These are the modern molecular taxonomic tools we are using. So next we go to automatic species identification. So we are consists of cyber tools are here. ELISE means automated leaf hopper identification system. DAISY means digital automatic identification system. ABIS means automatic bee identification system. SPIDA means species identified automatically system. Then spider, wasp, bee wings characters. Draw wings mean honey bee wing identification system. So new taxonomic tools are there. Ethological taxonomic tools are there. E-taxonomics resources are there. So these are the automatic species identifications are there. That means here we are go and search means we are seeing what are the namings, nomenclatures are there, which animals are classified, which animals are not classified, all the things we are seeing in this cyber tools. Here we are start finish the lesson living world. So living world, what are the things we are seeing in the living world lesson. So why we want to classify the animal. So diversity of the living world, needs of classification, taxonomy and systematics, 3 domain life cycle, and 7 kingdom classification, taxonomy of heritage, nomenclature. In the nomenclature, how they are giving our names, binomenclature, trinomenclature, concept of species. So tools for the study of taxonomy. Here we stop the finish the lesson. Thank you, children.